Hey folks, today we're in Dinkins Bottom in Yadkin County. We're going to talk a little bit about water hemp in particular. You know, if you look behind me, you can see the bridge. This farm had some water hemp in it this year that we think came in on the flood. This whole field and whole farm was flooded, and most of it tends to follow where the water was, so we think it moved that way. Water hemp, the reason we're going to talk about it is it's a new weed to North Carolina. It's not native. It comes from somewhere else, mostly the Midwest. And it tends to bring several resistances to it as well. So we think you need to know how to identify water hemp. We think you need to recognize that it looks an awful lot like palmer, but it probably has more resistances to it than palmer does, and that's going to make it more difficult to control. You know, one of the big problems with these pigweeds is they all look very similar. And if you treat them all the same, you might not get the kind of control you're after. My farmer here is really good. They're watching their crop close, and they knew the difference between a palmer pigweed and a water hemp before I came out here and talked to them about it. Back over my right shoulder, you can see a flag in the field there, and we've got a water hemp marked. They have done an excellent job of coming in and pulling, and they have pulled at least a truckload full of water hemp so far. And you know, that's a great practice. It's work, it's hard, it's hot in the summertime in North Carolina, but it removes a seed source from the field. And the first thing we want to do when we're trying to deal with these resistant weeds is we don't want to let them go to seed if at all possible. If they make a seed and that seed germinates, then we have to control it some other way, and it gets more and more difficult to control some of these resistant weeds every year. All right, this is a tall water hemp plant that we harvested out of this field back here, the one marked by the flag that you saw earlier. Obviously, it's a pretty big, robust plant. It's got multiple branches, and this thing's got the ability to make a lot of seed. It's got a pretty big, robust root system. You know, we didn't get all the roots. We dug it with a shovel. We stayed pretty close to the stalk, and you can see it's got a great big old stem on it too. So, water hemp is not quite as showy and as aggressive as a palmer pigweed is, but certainly one like this has got the ability to make a lot of seed. If the combine hits that and moves seed around, you know, you can move seed to multiple places in multiple fields. And I don't know if you can see it or not, but we do have a little bit of a flower structure starting to show on some of these tips. So we're getting ready to make water hemp seed before too long. One of the things you can see pretty quick is there's lots of little lateral branches that come out of just nearly every leaf node. And that's one of the issues that comes with trying to control any of the pigweeds, really. They have so many little lateral branches that we can control the top part of the plant. We can kill that. But if we don't kill it from the top to the root, all these little lateral branches are going to come back out. Now, one of the ways you can start to tell this water hemp from a palmer pigweed is the leaves are much narrower. There tends to be a lot more gloss on the leaf than with the palmer. The petioles will never be longer than the leaf is. If you remember, you know, we've talked about palmers before. This petiole portion right here, if you fold it over the leaf and it's longer, that's a good way to identify a palmer. Water hemp doesn't have that feature, so we don't worry about that. The stems are smooth, the leaves are smooth, there's no hairs, so you're looking for a narrower leaf, a lanceolate leaf. You're looking for smoothness, and that's a good way to start narrowing it down towards a water hemp. You know, I've mentioned once already that water hemp's difficult to control, and that's because it's not native to North Carolina. It comes from somewhere else, so we don't really know what's been used on it and what it's resistant to. This is the first population that I know of in Yadkin County. We've got three populations that are in Surry County. One of those has been tested for post-emerge chemicals, and that particular population of water hemp in Surry County, not many miles across the river from here, is resistant to five different modes of action. You know, that's big. We don't know exactly what might control it as a pre-emerge, but we do know that it's going to take multiple modes of action, both pre and post, to have a shot at controlling this thing with chemicals. So keep that in mind. It's going to take multiple modes of action. If you have questions about water hemp, about water hemp control, contact your local extension agent. They've got all kinds of resources available to them. They can help you find some answers that you might need to know.